वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग। डू वी नीड टू वेट और कैन वी स्टार्ट? या गुड मॉर्निंग, या सो इट्स ऑडिबल। चलो, लास्ट क्लास वी स्पोक ऑफ अटिकायुरेंस, ओके। नाउ बिफोर योर फ्रेंड्स जॉइन, वी ट्राई टू हैव अ स्मॉल रिविजन एंड slowly others will join and then we can continue with articoherence. So what did we discuss in the last class? We spoke of articoherence. I introduced you to articoherence. I gave you the characteristic symptoms. We also looked at the sphere of action of articoherence, okay, the ailments from, and of course the characteristic symptoms. Okay, now next 40 minutes what we'll try to do is we will try to talk of the particular symptoms, and as Artica is a partially proved remedy, we will typically not take the entire head to toe symptoms of Artica ailments. I'll mainly focus on three very important areas, and from the important to the we'll start with the most important thing in Artica urens. And what is that? That is very important for us in Artica urens. The primary area will be the skin. Okay, once we deal with skin, then we'll talk of the genitalia. So more than genitalia, I'll be concentrating on the chest, and even in chest we'll be talking of the mammary affections of articoherence. That will be our second objective. The first objective will be the skin, and second will be the lactation problems, where one often indicates articoherence. That will be the second objective. And the last or the third objective will be the rheumatic affections of articoherence. Okay, then we will talk of modalities. We will look at the clinical utility of articoherence, and then we can close the class. So this is what is planned for the next 40 minutes. I hope majority of your friends have joined. Okay, so shall we go ahead? So now what I wanted to focus here, as I was trying to tell you, for a final year student, theoretically and practically this area in Artica becomes very important for us. So what is it that we are trying to focus here is we are trying to understand the manifestation or what exactly Artica does acting on skin. If you remember, even before we started proving it homeopathically, Artica urens had some affinity for dermat problems. Okay, so now what could be the probable lesions that one expect Artica to cause? So this is something that I expect from you. What? Because we have already discussed that under the sphere of action and also under characteristic symptoms. So if you could quickly recall and tell me. Yes, very good. Mona is fast. Yes, Rajesh, good. Keep it up. Articaria. Yeah, Mala and majority of your friends. All your friends have something in common. What is that answer that is common? Is they are talking of articaria. Very good. So this is one practical indication of articoherence, and majority of the cases that I have treated in my clinic, especially articarias I am talking of. See, my approach in articaria has been more constitutional, because we assume articaria has a higher pathological things. We talk of the histamines, we talk of hormones, causing urticaria. So our approach should be more broader. Specifically, I have never treated urticaria giving remedies. Okay, or I have not got such peculiar symptoms in my clinical practice that I could not prescribe a specific remedy based on a specific PQRS symptom. Because majority of the times they come to us taking allopathic medicines, they would have been on antihistamines. Typically, when the itching increases, when the itching decreases, what is the character of itching? What is the character of eruptions? We might find it difficult to elicit. So my clinical practice, the approach has been more constitutional. Okay. And I have had very good results with urtica urens. So getting back to urtica urens, the remedy, what you see here is, we'll try to understand what causes urticarial rashes. Rajesh, good, also says not only urticaria, sir, we can think of urtica urens even in burns. Good. So we will talk of the symptoms related to skin of urticaria. To start with, as majority of you have contributed, the primary affection will be the skin. And you have the image here, it mainly causes urticaria. See, when you approach a case of urticaria, these are all the headings that one should remember. What causes urticaria? Each individual, based on his susceptibility, they might be sensitive to a particular substance. Now, in urtica urens, what brings on urticaria? There are some 5-6 ailments you should remember. Urticaria, typically in urtica urens, starts after bathing. Okay? Jayan says drugs and pollens. Good. But see, drugs and pollens are the causative factors of urticaria. But drugs and pollens need not cause urticarial rashes in urtica urens. So from what the PPT that you are seeing, bathing, exercise, stings of insect, shellfish, worm, these are the 5 causative factors which can give rise to urticarial eruptions in urtica urens. Okay? So I mean, pollens, dust, drugs can also cause urticarial rashes, but they will not fit into urtica urens. Jayant, I hope I am clear. Now, what exactly the rashes manifest as, or what exactly will be the complaints that they will have because of the rashes? So they have rashes, and these rashes will burn, and these rashes will itch. Now, when exactly the urticarial rashes aggravate in urtica urens? You have seen warmth as a causative factor, and I have been insisting from your first year, many of the causative factors can be an aggravating factors. May not be all, but few causative factors can also be an aggravating factor. Typically, the urticarial rashes, like aggravation night on becoming warm, or bed, when the bed starts becoming, when you start feeling the heat of the bed, and you know that warmth can aggravate the itching. Meaning they have urticarial rashes, and these rashes are more at night, or on becoming warm, or on becoming, on the bed becoming warm. These are the few aggravating factors. The only ameliorating factor you have in urtica urens, or this is the only remedy which has lying down amelioration as a causative factor. Lying down amelioration as a causative, as an ameliorating factor in the entire materia medica. So somebody tomorrow comes to your clinic and they say, sir, when I lie down, okay, my urticarial rashes disappear. The only remedy we have in our materia medica is urtica urens. This is very, very characteristic. Okay. So what else is characteristic in urtica urens when we talk of urticarial rashes? See, the urticarial rashes, eruptions which come annually, we saw this under the characteristic symptoms of Attica urens, that you know the eruptions which keep coming every year. So there is periodicity, annual symptoms coming up, and urticarial eruptions coming up annually. Again, the only remedy you have in your entire material. Okay, urticaria associated or alternating with rheumatism. This again very characteristic in Attica urens, and urticaria with pinworms. So you have a child who has urticarial rashes and he also has pinworms. When you have a combination of this, one can think of Attica urens as a remedy. Okay, so these are few PQRS symptoms that you will have to remember. That urticarial rashes ameliorating lying down, urticarial rashes coming up annually, urticaria associated or it alternates with rheumatism, and urticaria with pinworms. So these are very, very characteristic. Now, what else you can think of in urticaria urens? Okay, like for example, we discuss in the sphere of action, urticaria urens can also cause vesicular eruptions. And one such vesicular eruptions example we were talking of was chickenpox. And you know, one more lesion or a disease that can cause vesicular eruptions, that accumulation of fluid and all, could be burns. And we saw in the last class that Attica can be indicated for burns, especially in first and second degree burns. Okay. In the last class, we have extensively discussed the various remedies for burns, from causticum, from carbonic acid, from calendula. Okay. Lot of other remedies we have discussed. So let me not repeat the same thing here, because I would like to compare the urticarial rashes of other remedies. Okay, so burns mainly in first and second degree burns, you can think of Attica urens. Okay, so I hope I am clear with the skin affections. Whenever this question comes up in your exams, main focus will be on urticarial rashes. What causes urticarial rashes? And what will be the problems because of urticarial rashes? When it aggravates, when it ameliorates, and what was the PQRS symptoms of urticaria in Attica urens? So if you make a small totality, it will be worth. And apart from that, you can also comment on skin, the burns, and the vesicular eruptions like chickenpox. Okay. Now quickly, what remedies come to your mind when we talk of urticaria? Now before that, two of your friends, Jayant, has a question. Sir, if they have allergy because of some metal, what remedies can you think of? See, what remedies one can think of, especially when they have allergy to artificial metal, one remedy that strikes to my mind is stannum. Especially, when they have ear studs, and then if that ear stud area goes into an ulcer and all, one remedy that you need to think of here is stannum. Similarly, Rupesh has a question, belladonna, sir, can we think? Now, for what condition, Rupesh, you want to think of belladonna? I don't know in which context Rupesh has thought of belladonna, I'm not very clear. See, anyway, urticaria, though, we'll be comparing a lot of remedies. Now, few of your friends have contributed, very good. Apis mellifica, Bovista, okay, Restrox, good. So what we'll do is, I'll give you the indications. We can have a small quiz kind of an activity here. I will give you the indication of a remedy and you'll have to name the remedy. So are you ready to play this game? To start with, the remedies for urticarial rashes. To start with, I have this remedy. Urticaria, concentrate. It's not a buzz around, but anyway, concentrate. And you can answer. Urticaria from eating shellfish, insect bite, change of weather, with edema, urticaria in asthma troubles, urticaria during fever, itching, burning and stinging. So which is the remedy? It should not take so much of time. Which is the remedy? See, urtica urens that we have discussed. So it can't be urtica urens. Very good. Nagaraj has got it right. Okay, very good. I mean, Nagaraj, Pooja, Rajesh, good. Mega. All of you have got the answer right. And the answer is Apis mellifica. So in urticarial rashes, Apis has the following indications. So good going, we'll go to the second thing. Same thing, I'll give you the indication and you'll have to name the remedy. Urticaria after eating shellfish, urticaria with burning, itching, restlessness. See, this looks similar to Apis mellifica, but what is it that is very important? The practical clue here is the eruptions are smaller than Apis. Mona says Rustox, it's not Rustox, no problem. I know why Rustox came up here, because of the restlessness. Any other remedies that you can think of apart from Rustox? Very good. Arsenic, Mala, she has got the answer right. Okay, the right answer here is arsenic and Mala. I personally purposely did not use burning amelioration warmth. I know if I had used this symptom, you could have expected many more answers. But I wanted to keep this a little tricky, but Mala has got it right. Now, urticaria associated with diarrhea, kindly focus. After bathing, after excitement, during menses, urticaria nearly covering the whole body. Now, these are the symptoms. Now, from your side, which is the remedy? No, Bovista, Muni Lakshmita is behind Bovista, very good. It's not Bovista, I'll tell you when we think of Bovista. Any other remedies that you can think of? Mega says Lycopodium. So the remedy, what your friends have given, see, this is Bovista. See, Bovista is again a remedy, generally we neglect, it's a rare remedy, so we tend to neglect. Few of your friends have got it right. Let me tell you who have got it right. Munilakshmi, Pooja are two girls who spoke of Bovista. So Bovista is absolutely right. Okay. We'll go to the fourth question. Good going. So this is the fourth remedy. Urticaria, which mainly comes at night. Change of weather, urticaria with violent cough, aggravation warmth before menses, amelioration cold, amelioration after scratching. Now name the remedy. Three remedies that we spoke, you got it right. One was Apis, the other one was arsenic, the other one was Bovista. Yashasvini, let's see who gets it right. Okay, many of you have given sulfur, lycopodium. But Yashasvini's answer is right. The remedy is Dalcamara. Very good. No problem. See, at least I'm happy you are interacting. Brahmara says Rustox, no problem. The remedy is Dalcamara. Urticaria of gastric and uterine origin. Please read the symptoms carefully and then you can start answering. Urticaria with diarrhea. Urticaria which comes from emotions and urticaria from delayed menses. Okay, so I hope Pulsatilla, Yash says Pulsatilla. Okay, we'll see. Good, Pulsatilla. Any other remedies that you can think of? Pulse, Naxwamika, Mathura says Naxwamika. Chalo. See, urticaria of gastric origin and Yash thinking was right because Pulse is a remedy which also has a lot of emotions. Very good, lot of emotions. Yashasvini talks of Ignitia, but Yash has already got the answer right. The answer is Pulsatilla. Very good. And focus on the next question. Urticaria and cold air during fever, after scratching, from becoming wet, and urticaria which comes in every spring. In every spring season, the patient will have urticarial rashes. or whenever he gets wet, he has urticarial rashes. I feel this question should be pretty easy. Yeah, Pooja, Rustox. Let's see if it is Rustox. Yes, Deepik also supports, and both of you have got the answer right. Good. The answer is Rustox. See, I hope you are getting the PQRS indications of the remedies. Urticaria after eating meat, urticaria from overexertion. Only remedy you have, for example, somebody consumes meat and then they develop urticarial rashes, or urticaria which comes after overexertion. So, which is the remedy? I mean, majority of you have got the remedies right till now. This is a remedy which is a little tricky. So, somebody had told Antim Crude, little, see, Deepika, Apis mellifica is already over, so I'll not talk of Apis again. Think of remedies that we have already finished. Nagraj says Ruta, but the answer is already there. No problem. The answer is Antimonium Crudum. Okay? Yeah, this is again a very nice question, and it's a nice remedy. See, urticaria after violent exercise. So, for example, if they are doing gymming or if they are doing some violent exercise, they develop urticarial rashes. And see the other beautiful symptom here. The urticarial rashes here are typically white. So generally we see that reddish rashes. In this remedy, the urticarial rashes are white. So which is the remedy which has white urticarial rashes? The only remedy in our Materia Medica, and which comes after violent exercise. No? It's a little tricky, but once you get the answer, see the answer, you'll feel disappointed. It's a very common remedy, and it is Natrum Muriaticum. Okay? And see, this is again a rare remedy. I don't know how many of you, yeah, Savita is a little late, but anyway, Natrum Mur, right answer. Chronic urticaria in children and urticaria associated with constipation. It's a rare remedy, so don't think of sepia, don't think of arsenic, don't think of Naxvamika. It's a very rare remedy. I don't know if it is there in your syllabus, but you should know. The remedy is Copaiba. A rare remedy, it is Copaiba. This again is a rare remedy that I am going to give you next. Urticarial rashes after alcohol, after wine, or after a person suddenly becomes chill, he gets urticarial rashes. The only remedy that you should remember here is Chloralum. It's a rare remedy. I don't use it, so even getting the pronunciation right might be a little difficult. So last 5-6 minutes, what we have done is, we have tried to take up those common remedies that we indicate in our clinic for urticaria, and we have tried to compare, and we try to make this session interactive. And thank you. Many of you have got the answers right, and many of you have interacted in a very nice way. Thanks for that, and we'll move ahead. So I hope the skin, as a small revision, you are clear. We'll focus on urticarial rashes, burns, and chickenpox. Three important things that we have to remember in under skin in urtica urens. Now, what do you expect here? I've shown this image before. I have not changed the image. I've kept the image same so that you can recall the image, and you can also tell me what exactly you have here in this particular remedy. What do you see here? Why is this lady here, and what symptoms do we have in urtica urens? So what do you expect here in urtica urens? Very good. Yes. Good. Mala, Muni Lakshmi, Agalactia, suppressed milk. Very good. Yes, again Rajesh has the same thing. Good, keep it up. Now what you see here in urtica urens will be basically that they will have problems or complaints related to lactation. I made this point very clear even when I took up the characteristic symptoms, that this is a remedy which will cause disturbances in lactation. I'll just share a small case. Few of your friends would have listened to this case. I discussed this in a webinar a few days back, But I'll just share a small case related to lactation. We had this young mother who delivered very recently, 21 or 22 was her age, and she was referred by one of your senior, and this girl had problems with lactation. Now, what was the problem was, she was not having issues with lactation, meaning she was lactating properly, but the child was not able to suck the milk. Okay, I'll not go into the details of the case because we have another 10-15 minutes and I need to finish articulations. I'll cut short this case, and what was the problem was, the child was not able to suck the milk, milk was getting formed, and child had no oral problems, oral issues. But what the mother observed, or the mother-in-law and her mother observed, was the milk was both gada. She was trying to tell us it was very thick milk. Okay, there was no issues with the taste. It was not tasting bad. It was not tasting bitter. Everything was fine. But the only problem why the child was not able to suck was the milk was very thick. And this girl had to squeeze the milk, extract the milk manually, and they had to feed the child. Now, this is the problem for which the mother came to me, and a simple remedy was prescribed. And you know, the rubric that we took was milk thick. What mother told, same thing. We put it into a repertory. We searched for this rubric in repertory, and we have only two remedies having milk which is thick. One is borax, the other one is Calipike. And this lady also had fear of cancer, and she also had this. What was that? She also had was problem was, she had a problem, and that problem was the milk was getting formed too much. So there was excess milk getting formed. Every 2 hours, the mother had to literally or manually extract the milk. It was a painful procedure, and the milk was thick. A dose of borax was given, and we have a follow-up video of this case. Mother, after 15 days, when she gets back to us, she is very happy. See, I mean, what a right homeopathic remedy can do, fine. So milk, I mean, I was also shocked because borax had never used for lactation problems. As such, women coming to me for lactational issues are very few. I don't have a big experience in this area. Very rarely we come across patients asking for increased milk formation, or they say, doctor, there is excess milk, please give some medicines so that the milk gets drained, the milk gets dried. So these are the probable complaints they come to us with. But unusually, we had this lady with milk that was thick, and after borax, she gives us a video where she says the milk has started becoming thin, there is no pain, child is able to suck, and things like that. You know, a girl, young girl who had come to me with severe pain, severe agony, after 15 days, you see a broad smile on her face. मैं सोच सकता हूँ डॉक्टर साहब, मिल्क उतना प्रॉब्लम नहीं, जैसा नॉर्मल आता है ना ऐसा आ रहा है. सो दैट वॉज अ वेरी नाइस फॉलो अप. रेमेडी वॉज बोरेक्स. ओके, सो हियर वॉट डू वी हैव इन अर्टिका यूरेन्स. वी सॉ दैट देर इज डिस्टर्बेंस इन लैक्टेशन, एंड वॉट वी ऑल्सो सॉ इज द मिल्क सेक्रीशन बिकम्स डिक्रीज्ड. ओके, वी ऑल्सो स्पोक ऑफ अदर रेमेडीज. विच वर द अदर रेमेडीज वी स्पोक in the last class? There is, see, it was not stringy. Jayant has a question, was the milk stringy? It was not stringy, the milk was thick. Good, it is not stringy. Stringy is what you see in Calipike. Any discharge in Calipike, especially from the nose, especially when they cough, it is a stringy discharge. Okay, so here more than the stringiness, it was more of thick. Good. The other remedies that we have for diminished secretion of milk, alfalfa, eustilago, very good, Agnus castus, Attica urens, and Rajesh also has Netranure, very good. All the five remedies, you have got it right. So here there is diminished secretion of milk. And yes, Divya also says costicum. Good, costicum is also there. See, there are two things that you'll have to remember in urticaria arrhythmias. Two polarities. One, when the milk flow is diminished, you give urticaria arrhythmias, it will increase the milk secretion. One. The second opposite indication of urticaria arrhythmias will be that there is excess flow, and you know mother is not able to wean off. So if urtica gets indicated and if you give urtica urines, it will help in drying the milk. So both the things you have in urtica urines, you should be careful, and you should use this properly. Yeah, there are a lot of other remedies: lactan, agnus castus, pulsatilla, murk. Lot of remedies. You have to keep it in your mind, and use your intellect and indications of the remedies. You should understand properly. And then you start prescribing milk in non-pregnant women, okay? And swelling of mammae with stinging and burning pains. So this slide, swelling of mammae with secretion of milk. The entire slide talks of the lactation problems in a lactating mother and the utility of urtica urines in the above condition. Okay. Now, if this is clear, we'll talk of the last area in urtica, and the area that we'll be focusing will be the joint affections. See, talking of joints, two or three small areas urtica gets indicated. One is, it can be a very good remedy for acute and chronic gout. More than that, pain in the deltoid muscle. Okay, you know that deltoid muscle, where generally IM injections are given. So that muscle, they will have bad pain, and for example, if they have to remove their shirt or if they have to wear their shirt, they find it very difficult. So this is a practical indication one need to remember. So the deltoid muscle, pain in the deltoid muscle, pain in wrist, ankle, foot, but this is what I want to focus. Pain in the right deltoid region, okay, and they find rotating or even putting the coat in, they might have problems. So mainly the right deltoid will be affected. If the left deltoid gets affected, the remedy is Nux muscata. Okay, again a remedy which I have written it for you. If it is right, it can be Kalmia, it can be Cedron, Causticum, Cardus marinus, Agaricus. Left, you have Nux muscata. Gouty deposits in fingers, the metacarpal joints, one can think of urtica urines. So this slide dedicated for the joint affections of urtica urines. So when I started, I told you the entire urtica we will be discussing under three important headings. One will be the skin. The focus there was mainly the urticarial rashes. Then the second thing was we spoke of the lactation problems, and third thing is the joint affections in urtica urines. Now this slide again can be a very important slide as you are a final year student. Clinically, where do we indicate urtica urines? Can I have some inputs, some quick inputs? Which are all the clinical conditions in which one can think of urtica urines? Some quick inputs from your side. Yeah, clinical indications. What are those clinical conditions where one can think of urtica urine? Good, gout. Yes, again gout. Urticaria, gout. Yes, chalo. We have plenty. To start with, yes, Bramara something, lactation problems, agalactia. Good. Burns, yes, very good. Bramara, splenomegaly with headaches, hepatomegaly, gout, urticaria, chickenpox, burns. Yeah, now we have a lot of answers coming up. Rheumatism, sleeplessness. Now, what is the cause for sleeplessness in urtica urine? I told you this is the only remedy which has a specific cause for sleeplessness. So, what causes sleeplessness in urtica? Very good. Mala gets it fast, gets it right. Itching and burning in scrotum. Good, keep it up. Itching and burning in scrotum. Okay. Yes. Now allergies. Now what causes hemoptysis? What causes hemoptysis? Yeah, Deepika. Okay, what causes hemoptysis? Like sleeplessness, you have something very characteristic in Attika. Again, Mala. Okay, Swati, good. Violent exertion. Good, keep it up. Violent exertion brings on hemoptysis. Which were the other two remedies we spoke? Which were the other two remedies? One was millifolium and the other one was ipecac. Millifolium and ipecac. Okay. So lactation disturbances, periodical affections. What is that periodical affection you have in urticaria? What is that periodical indication you have in urticaria urens? I already gave the answer. Urticaria. Angio, neurotic edema, yes. Bee stings, delta rheumatism, gravel in the urine, and pinworms. You can take a pick. These are all the things that you have in urticaria urens. Okay, clinical indications. Okay. Now, what aggravates and what ameliorates? You got plenty of aggravating factors here. Exposure to snow, cool bathing, lying on arm, violent exertion, warmth, yearly, touch, sleep, night. These are all the aggravating factors. And the only ameliorating factor you have in urticaria urine will be lying down. They feel better by lying down, especially urticaria. That's the only ameliorating factor I could get from books. Lying down ameliorates. Okay. Yeah. So this was in detail about urticaria urens. First class, introducing to urticaria. We spoke of characteristic symptoms, ailments from. In the second class, we concentrated on the skin, the lactation problems, the rheumatism, the clinical indications, and the modalities. We have some 3 minutes time. If you have any questions or if you want me to repeat anything, something that you have not followed, feel free. We have 3 minutes. I'll be more than happy to take up the questions. Or let me just go through the chat box. If you have asked some questions and if you have not seen it, I'll just have a look. Bramara also says, so clinically it can be indicated for dropsy. Yes, dropsy because of liver or spleen affections, you can think of urticaria urens. Good. Let me go through if we have any more. Yeah, majority of you have contributed, but no questions, or what questions you have asked, I have already answered. You have anything to ask? If you have nothing to ask, we'll close the class, and hopefully next Saturday we'll meet again. I have some 3 remedies with me. If I'm right, I have Sambucus, I have Veratrum Viridae, and one more, Vinca Minora. These are the 3 remedies. So we'll see. I'll either start with Vinca. Okay, prepare Vinca. Vinca Minora. It's a very small remedy. Must be in one class. We can finish Vinca Minora. So next class we'll talk of Vinca Minora. Okay. So no doubts. No doubts for a teacher can be a nice thing. Yeah. One second. There are some questions coming up. Sir, suppressed milk secretions and disturbances are diminished. Both are different, right, sir? What actually? Yeah. Yes, good. So Yash has a very nice question, very practical question. See, that's what I was trying to tell you. We'll go back to the slide. That's what I was trying to tell you. You know, in urticaria, if you see this slide, in urticaria you have you focus on this. See, based on the complaints they come to you with. See, now this, if you see the slide that I have focused on the left hand side, this is what happens immediately after the mother has delivered the child, and then she is not able to feed the child because there is diminished secretion. It's a nice question what she wants to know. Now here, if this remedy gets indicated, and if you indicate urticaria urens, it can act on the lactating ducts, and it can improve the production of milk. Fine, you know it's a different mechanism. Fine, from the pituitary, all this whatever happens from your physiology knowledge. So urtica can improve the secretion of milk. Yes, this is one indication. Okay. Now, for example, in the extreme end, for example, after 9 months, 10 months, after a year, when the mother wants to stop, okay, I'm not talking of the same mother. Don't get confused. I'm not talking of the same mother. It could be a different lady. It could be entirely a new lady, new patient who comes to you, and she wants to consult you with this problem. And what is the problem? That, you know, the milk secretion is still there, and it's been more than a year, or it's been 14 months, 15 months, and, you know, in spite of she stopping the feeding part, the milk continues. So here you can think of urtica if it is indicated. And urtica here again, you know, acts and it helps in drying the milk. Yes, I hope it's clear. And through Yes, it's a nice question, and many of you, I assume, got an answer for this. It was a little confusing. It has both to increase, and it can also dry the milk secretion. Okay, anyway, good question. Any more questions? Yeah, chalo, then we'll close. If you have no questions, our time is also coming to an end. The class will come to an end today. So next week I have given you a remedy. Please prepare and come, so that we'll have better interaction, and we can understand vinca minora, a very simple remedy, in a better way. Thank you. Thank you all.